Today's video is about conditional formatting in Excel. I'm going to show you how you can use formulas in conditional formatting and how you can conditionally format a range based on the value of another cell. So for example, conditionally format a row in Excel based on a cell's value in that row. This way you can highlight a row or adjust the font color of a row based on another cell. It's going to be fun. Let's get to it. In this example, I have a list of names and the yearly salary for each person. I want to format the values or the rows if the salary is greater than or equal to the salary I type in here. So I'm going to do two different versions of this. In the first version, I just want to highlight the values. In the second version, I want to highlight the rows where this condition is true. Because I'm adjusting the formatting based on a condition, I need to use conditional formatting. So first thing I need to do is highlight the range I want to format, go to conditional formatting, and apply a new rule. I need to use a formula to determine which cells to format because the formatting of these cells is dependent on the value of another cell, and I can check that with a formula. I input the formula in here. Conditional formatting is going to check whether the result of this formula is true or false. If it's true, it's going to apply the formatting that I define here. If it's false, it's going to leave the formatting as is. So it all comes down to the formula in here. So I'm going to start off with the equal sign. Now, what type of formula do you write? Well, here's the other rule when using conditional formatting. The formula that you type is always from the point of view of the first cell in the range that you've highlighted. So it's from the point of view of B6 in this case. Now I want to check if this is greater than or equal to B3 here. Notice as I'm doing the cell references here, Excel is automatically fully fixing the cell reference. It's putting the dollar sign for both the column and the row. So is this going to work? Well, let's try it. I'm going to apply the formatting that I want. Once you go to format, you can select between number, font formatting, so you can adjust the font color or make the font bold or italic. You can adjust the border and the fill color. So in this case, I'm just going to go with the fill color and click on OK. That was my formula, right? Actually, I'm just going to copy it as well and click on OK. Nothing happens. Why? Because B6 is not greater than 80,000. If I change this to 80,000 or 81,000, because my formula was greater than or equal to, everything is green. Why? Because all of these cells are looking at this cell here. I'm just going to press Ctrl Z to go back. This is the confusing part when you use a formula inside conditional formatting, because you're basically typing a formula that's applied from the point of view of the first cell, but then you have to imagine how that formula would be if you pull it down to the other cells. And not all of us can easily imagine this. So here's a trick you can use. I've seen Mike Gervin use this. It's a great way of visualizing everything on the grid. I really love this solution, so I'm gonna share it with you here. What you need to do is type in your formula on the grid right beside your values. So I copied it before, so I'm just going to paste it in. That's the formula we had in conditional formatting. Now the result of this is false because 60,000 to 70 is not greater or equal to 80,000. When you pull this down, the result is also false because they're always looking at the value in B6. I want to make this dynamic. So either I have to remove the dollar sign for the 6 or completely remove the dollar sign. So let's just send this down. And now we get true wherever the value is greater than 80,000 and false where it's not. This means all I need to do is go back and update my conditional formatting rule by applying this formula and everything should work. The only change was to remove the dollar signs for B6. So I'm just going to go back to conditional formatting. Now, anytime you want to edit a rule, you can go to Manage Rules. Let's go and edit the rule and adjust this by removing the dollar signs. Is this going to work? We'll know when we click on OK, but before I do that, take a look to see if you're already subscribed to this channel. And if you aren't and you like the type of videos you see here, consider subscribing. So now let's go with OK. And everything is dynamic. I don't need this help anymore. I'm going to remove it. Let's double check. If this goes to 80,000, it automatically gets highlighted. I can also adjust my number here. So if I go with 90,000, my formatting updates as well. Okay, so I'm just going to go with Control Z to go back. Now let's figure out how we can highlight the rows instead of just the values. Well, here again, it comes down to the correct fixing. Let's do it on the grid first before we copy it to the conditional formatting dialog box. Now remember, the conditional formatting is going to be applied to both of these, right? So for both name and yearly salary. And I'm just going to bring the titles here so we know where we are at each stage. The formula that I type in the box is going to be applied from the point of view of the first cell here, which is going to be E6. Now E6 needs to always look at the value in F6 and compare it against this one here. Now I know that this is the number I need to fully fix, so I'm going to press F4 to fully fix this. But what about F6? Can I leave it like this? Well, we can quickly check. If I bring this over and down, it doesn't really work because here I get true and here I get false. Why is this false here? Well, because it's moving to the next column. Why is it true here? Because it was on the right column. This means I can't leave this fully dynamic like I did before. I actually have to fix the column to make sure it doesn't shift. So I'm going to press F4 a few times. Make sure F is fixed, that's not going to go to G as this is pulled across and sent down. Now I get true for these rows. Okay, so this is the type of trick you can use to get conditional formatting right every time you're using a formula. Now all I have to do is copy this, highlight my range here, go to conditional formatting, new rule, use a formula, paste in the range, and apply the type of format I want. I'm going to go with green. We can also make the font bold and OK and OK. I don't need these helper cells anymore, so I'm just going to remove them. Now, when you use conditional formatting, there is something you need to be aware of. Every time you copy a range that has conditional formatting and you paste it somewhere else, you bring the conditional formatting with. If you don't want that, you can remove it by going to Conditional Formatting, Clear Rules, and clearing the rules from the selected cells. You can also clear the rules from the entire sheet, and it will remove all of your conditional formatting. Now, another way of copy and pasting so that you don't have to do this step is to copy your range, go to the side here, right mouse click, go to Paste Special, and select formulas and number formats in case you have formulas in your cells or values and number formats. And then after you click on OK, you get your number formatting and your values, but you don't get your conditional formatting come with. Okay, so something to keep in mind if you're copying and pasting your ranges. So that's how you can use formulas in conditional formatting. You can use it to highlight a row based on another cell, but you can, of course, use it also with more complex formulas. Just remember that conditional formatting formats those cells where your formula returns true. So if it's not working, double check on the grid, so basically on your Excel spreadsheet directly, to see where the problem might be. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, consider subscribing so that I can see you in the next video.